Oh, no, you're fine.
They're going to be coming right through here. Yeah, so if you stay right here, you'll be fine.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the presentation of colors by the Heritage High School Color Guard, representing the United States Air Force Junior Reserve Officer Training Corps. Tonight's Color Guard is led by Cadet Major Brennan Power. As they approach, please join me in congratulating our JROTC for completing over 1,700 hours of community service, earning a Distinguished Unit Award while developing leaders who are pursuing cutting-edge careers in aviation, cybersecurity, private sector management, and public service. Heritage High School in the Liberty Union High School District is proud to host one of only two Air Force JROTC units in Contra Costa County. Please remain standing for the national anthem performed by Heritage High School Senior Choir and our band under the direction of Ms. Kimberly Shanker and Mr. Jeffrey Kumagai. Please remain standing as the colors are retired. Please be seated. Good evening, students, staff, families, and friends. Begin the commencement exercise for the Heritage High School. I want to take a moment to introduce and welcome some of our honored guests who have come to celebrate with us. Some of our distinguished guests with me on the stage are President of the Board for the Liberty Union High School District, Ms. Yolanda Pena Mendrick. Clerk of the Board of Trustees for the Liberty Union High School District, Dr. Tamala Hawley. Member of the Board for the Liberty Union High School District, Mrs. Pauline Allred. Member of the Board for the Liberty Union High School District, Ms. Sandy McCaslin. Member of the Board for the Member of the Board for the Liberty Union High School District, Ms. Susan Wallace. Superintendent of Schools for the Liberty Union High School District, Mr. Eric Volta. Seated in our VIP section this evening, Associate Superintendent for Human Resources, Ms. Denise Rigani. Cynthia Cabello. Assistant Business. Also here to celebrate with us this evening are council members for the City of Brentwood, Vice Mayor Susanna Meyer. Representing District 1, Ms. Jovita Mendoza. Representing District 2, Ms. Nisha. Representing the City of Brentwood's Police Department, Captain David Schroer. Officer Michael Gibson. Officer Matt King. Thank you all and welcome. Class of 2023, 4 years ago you were freshmen, starting your high school careers and beginning to create your legacy here at Heritage High School. Many of the adults seated in the audience this evening have stories about their individual high school journeys. But what sets your class apart from the rest of the adults in attendance tonight is that the class of 2023 has a collective historic story. My guess is that many of the speakers you hear this evening will refer to portions of this unique journey your class has taken over the last 4 years. To say this journey was a difficult one would be an understatement. Nevertheless, you persisted, and you sit before your friends and family this evening having fulfilled 270 graduation credit requirements. Yep, it's a lot. And many of you fulfilling the UC A to G requirements. Graduation is a rite of passage, crossing a threshold from years of hard work and dedication into a new beginning of a next stage of life. As I stand up here this evening, I would simply like to say, class of 2023, I am proud of you. I am proud of each of you. Former President Barack Obama, in his national commencement address to the class of 2020 during the COVID-19 pandemic, said, "All these adults that you used to think were in charge and knew what they were doing, it turns out that they don't have all the answers. A lot of them aren't even asking the right questions." So this is my challenge to you, class of 2023, to ask the right questions. Challenge the status quo, especially when the status is put in place to hurt or make human beings feel othered. Dream big, set goals, and work hard for your future self and the future of our country, always keeping in mind to do what is right, not what is easy, convenient, or feels temporarily good. Congratulations, class of 2023, and keep making us proud. Now it is my pleasure to invite our superintendent, Mr. Volta, to say a few words to the class of 2023.
Thank you, Ms. Wells. Good evening, Heritage class of 2023. I would like to speak directly to you because, frankly, faculty and staff are probably tired of listening to me. And parents and families have long ago started deleting my COVID updates and are now programmed to mentally delete my brief words tonight. Or in the case of your sophomore year, log on to 2,333 days of school. If you came to school on average, you attended approximately 2,193.1 days since your first day of kindergarten. Some of you that were worried of missing class for fear of your grades dropping went better than that 93% average. Others who maybe weren't so worried, well, at least you attended tonight. These last 13 years may seem like a long time, and it was, but not really. As someone who has been around a little while, I sometimes struggle to instill in young adults that this is just the beginning. and you will most likely find yourselves feeling only a little bit older and a little bit wiser 40 years from now, as I have. But a number of years ago, I came across a poem by Linda Ellis called The Dash. It was recited at a memorial, but I thought the poem had so much more meaning for those that were starting their adult lives than for those that were older. Our beds are already made. The poem about that is about that small line on a person's marker that sits between the year they were born, for you, 2004 or 2005, and the year we pass. To quote a stanza from that poem, "For that dash represents all the time that they spent alive on earth. And now only those who love them know what that little line is worth." What will that dash mean for those that love or will love you? What will it represent? You are very fortunate that that dash is less than 25% complete. If that dash currently represents compassion, integrity, friendship, dedication, or any other virtue, congratulations, keep it up. For the next 50 plus years, you'll be adding worth and meaning to that dash. For those of you society, it's the beginning of adult life. You have not yet reached, nor have even come close to the number of those that will come to love you and add meaning to your dashes. Tonight, and maybe for a couple of times in your life, you get to have a do-over, a reset. For our graduates, after distance learning, quarantines, learning Canvas, social distancing, and forgetting whether or not the mute is on Zoom, I can think of no other graduating class that has garnered more love and respect of educators for your perseverance. Patriots, I have walked your halls and visited your classrooms and Zoom rooms. I have attended a number of events and watched you win league championships. From what I have seen, heard, and experienced, I am confident that each and every one of you will have a meaningful and positive dash. On behalf of the district, we are proud of you and your accomplishments. Class of 2023, I wish you the best of luck on your last day of school and the first night as official adults in our community. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Volta. At this time, I would like to take a moment to thank our entire faculty and staff of Heritage High School, especially those present this evening who give their free time to support our students. Staff in attendance this evening, please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Our commencement ceremony is a time to honor outstanding graduates. This year, I want to start by recognizing the following student for perfect attendance every day during their 4 years at Heritage. And I must say, in talking to this student's parent, I believe perfect attendance since kindergarten. McKenna Law, please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Additionally, I'm proud to recognize the many seniors this evening who have distinguished themselves with various accomplishments at Heritage. These graduates are wearing honor cords, tassels, stoles, and medallions, which are clearly identified in your program. This evening, 13 seniors are being recognized for their academic achievement as members of Air Force JROTC program at our school and are wearing white stoles. Air Force JROTC students, please stand and be recognized for your achievement. Great work. This evening, 30 seniors are being recognized for their outstanding academic accomplishments. They have membership status in the California Scholarship Federation and are wearing gold honor cords and gold tassels. CSF students, please stand and be recognized for your achievement. Well done. This evening, 35 seniors are being recognized for their academic achievement as members of the National Honor Society. They are wearing royal blue and gold honor stoles. NHS students, please stand and be recognized for your hard work. Excellent job. This evening, 4 seniors are being recognized for their achievement as members of the National Art Honor Society. They are wearing multicolored honor cords. National Art Honor Society students, please stand and be recognized for your accomplishment. Good job. This evening, 10 seniors are being recognized for their outstanding achievement as members of the International Thespian Society. They are wearing dark blue stoles and medallions with blue and gold ribbon. Would you please stand and be recognized for your accomplishment? Nice job. This evening, 1 senior is being recognized for their outstanding achievement as a member of the Interact Club and Rotary International. They are wearing a yellow stole. Please stand and be recognized for your accomplishment. Congratulations. This evening, 12 seniors are being recognized for their outstanding accomplishments as members of the Key Club. They are wearing dark blue cords. Would you please stand and be recognized for your work? Thank you. This evening, 17 seniors are being recognized for their outstanding achievement, earning their letter in leadership. They are wearing light blue and gold honor cords. Would you please stand and be recognized for your achievement? I'm pausing for a second just because just wanted to make sure I didn't skip something, but I didn't. All right. This evening, 93 seniors are being recognized for their fulfillment of the required coursework within an academy. These students are wearing a medallion which depicts our 4 academies on campus. Arts and entrepreneurial graduates wear medallions with yellow ribbons. Health graduates wear medallions with red ribbons. Public service graduates wear medallions with blue ribbons, and technology graduates wear medallions with white ribbons. Would all Academy students please stand and be recognized for your accomplishment? Thank you. This evening, 62 seniors are being recognized for their academic accomplishments. They have attained a high level of proficiency in speaking, reading, and writing 1 or more languages in addition to English, qualifying them as Biliteracy Award honorees. They are wearing medallions with black ribbon. Please stand and be recognized for your achievement in language. Great job. This evening, 77 seniors are being recognized for their outstanding academic accomplishments. They have earned a final grade point average of a 4.0 or above. They are wearing Light of Knowledge Principal's Honor Cord. Principal's Award honorees, please stand and be recognized for your academic achievement. Congratulations. I now have the pleasure of introducing this year's senior speaker, Emma Crennel. Emma, please come forward.
Thank you, Mrs. Wells. I spoke at my eighth grade promotion back there at Adams 4 years ago, and there was a lot less people, but hi, everyone. Good evening, family, teachers, faculty, and most importantly, the class of 2023. I'm so honored to be able to speak to you all tonight. As I reflected on what I wanted to share with you today, I had many ideas come to mind. I thought maybe I could reference the infamous pandemic, or the challenges of AP exams, or even the struggles of navigating the student parking lot, but I landed on something a little bit different, the power of words. I have realized the importance of words and how they have played a significant role in not only my life as a poet, but in each of our lives. Throughout high school, as 21st century teenagers, we have had the world at our fingertips. Literally, with the click of a button, double tap, or swipe, we constantly hold the power to have an impact on someone else's life. Social media is our sphere, but as we enter the reality of the world, we must be intentional about how we choose to use the power that we possess. Using your voice is not just about using words. It's about discovering who you are and what you stand for. It's about connecting with others and making people feel seen, understood, and heard. It's about having the courage to speak up for what you believe in, even if you're the only voice in the room. As we take the next steps towards our future, we will encounter difficult decisions, navigate new places, and confront our own fears and doubts. But if we can discover our voice and help others find their own, our generation will have done something right. Honesty, equality, respect, integrity, trust, achievement, generosity, and excellence. Those words you will find etched around the iconic juicer. Which one of these words will you carry with you as your journey as a patriot comes to a close and your life beyond high school begins? On behalf of my graduating class, I would like to say thank you to all the teachers and parents. You genuinely have taught us so much, and although we might not know it yet, you have all made an impact on each and every one of us. Thank you for the life lessons and the words of encouragement, for taking that extra minute to help us when we needed it, and for always being supportive of our dreams. As we look ahead towards the future, we will never forget what we have learned here as a patriot. The numerous memories are moments we will cherish forever and take with us onto the next chapter. Finally, I must admit that I have always hated endings, but they're inevitable. Mr. Worldwide Pitbull once stated, "This is for everybody going through tough times. Believe me, been there, done that. But every day above ground is a great day. Remember that." Congratulations, class of 2023. We did it.
Thank you, Emma. I didn't know she spoke at her eighth grade promotion, but that's amazing. This evening, we also have a musical treat for you. Please welcome Heritage High School's senior musicians with a special performance of Everybody Wants to Rule the World, words and music by Ian Stanley, Roland Orzabal, and Chris Hughes.
Thank you.
Great job. Please give them another round of applause as they return to their seats. The salutatorian for the Heritage High School Class of 2023 is Raziel Ardaniel. Raziel graduates with a total GPA of 4.46 and is on her way to De La Salle University in the Philippines to pursue an undergraduate nursing degree. She would like to eventually go to medical school to become a neurosurgeon. Raziel is an AP scholar with distinction, was the girls' state delegate for the American Legion Auxiliary, and is a member of National Honor Society and California Scholarship Federation. She has earned the Seal of Biliteracy in Spanish. Raziel is president of Filipino American Club and HOSA. In addition, she volunteers her time serving as vice president for Educated Angel, a community-based tutoring organization. Congratulations, Raziel, on being named salutatorian for Heritage High School's Class of 2023. Raziel, please come forward.
Okay, Filipino height. Kumusta kayo, mga pamilya? Woo, it's really nice to see your faces. I only have a few things to impart with you as I was blessed with the opportunity to speak with you all one final time. And I'd like to share with you the experience I've had. Being an immigrant child, I entered high school believing that the only thing that mattered was getting good grades and rising to the top. And I truly believed that for several years, to the point that I would shut everything else out in my life just for more time to work. I thought that was all to life until I met some people who shifted my perspective, who were kind and understanding. And there were many teachers who showed me grace when I faltered, such as Mr. Leong, Ms. Hinojosa, Ms. Valdez, and the Penningtons. And I'll never forget the role models who went above and beyond in their duties and were so instrumental in my time here, such as Ms. Valdez, Ms. Polk, Colonel Morris, and Pash. I'll always be grateful for you all. To my organizations that I was a part of, thank you for giving me guidance and compassion for teaching me to do the same to others. To everyone in Phil-Am, thank you for celebrating my culture, which I was once afraid to do. Thank you for giving me a way to positively impact the community with my experience and for blessing me with some of the best people I've ever met. I was so happy coming in every Friday to see your bright and smiling faces, and I loved being an ate to you. To everyone in HOSA, thank you for being the strongest leaders I know, for guiding me through high school and uniting us under our love for medicine. You're the ones who taught me how to balance my school and personal life and make time for the things that made me happy. To everyone in Educated Angel, thank you for blessing the community by being both tutors and friends to all of our students. You've changed so many lives and will continue to do so long after I've left. You guys are the thing I'm proudest of in high school. You were central to my being, and I'm proudest to be part of the group. First time. To my friends who have changed my life, thank you for loving me and for allowing me to do the same. We forged invaluable memories wrought with smiles and laughter, and you taught me to be a better person, to choose happiness every day. My family, my greatest motivators and my strongest supporters. Thank you for my mom and my dad for always being patient with me and all my ambition and with all the responsibilities I took on, for being understanding when I was at my worst and for still loving me. To my sister and brother, thank you for always making me laugh and breaking into my room when I'm studying just to cheer me up, and for taking breaks from life just to sing with me over the piano. And of course, thank you, God, for blessing my family and I, and for giving us the opportunities to forge our path in this country. Thank you for changing my perspective, all of you. Thank you for changing my perspective and for giving blessings in my life. Thank you for teaching me to lean on others and not always to my own understanding. I don't negate the struggles of the past years, and I acknowledge that it hasn't been easy, while constantly adapting to new landscapes and challenges. But the class of 23 has proven that in the face of adversity, we stand strong and united, that we may turn to our brothers and sisters in times of difficulty and be met with kindness. And I know that you will do things that will impact people for generations, not just through any technological innovation, but through the kindness and compassion you show through others and through the bonds that you forge. In all you do and through all your ambition, never forget to look after one another. And may the lives that we touch be a legacy. God bless you, and ingat kayo.
Thank you, Raziel. Valedictorian for the Heritage High School class of 2020, Tien Hua. Tien, otherwise known to his friends as the absolute academic weapon, graduates with a total GPA of 4.53 and will be attending UCLA, then medical school, to practice family medicine. Tien's accomplishments are varied across multiple disciplines, along with his academic accomplishments, including passing 16 AP classes, all with A's. He is a second degree black belt and spends time working at Kumon as a math and reading tutor. He was voted by his peers as the best math student in the senior class. And as a junior, Tien competed for the Heritage High School team, where he competed in the state quarterfinals. Congratulations, Tien, on being named valedictorian for Heritage High School's. And please come forward.
Hey guys, what's better than one valedictorian? Two valedictorians! Hi everybody. You guys might not know me. I am Tien and we went to school together. I guess right now I'm tasked with writing up a farewell speech for our graduating class. So right now I would like to start off with commemorating everyone who came here. So please, let's clap for these people. Thank you to the students who attended graduation today. You worked really, really hard to get here. Thank you to Mrs. Wells, the staff, and faculty for providing the school with the best possible education for their students. Thank you to the teachers with me throughout my 4 years. That would be you, Ms. Favalor, Ms. Hannigan, Mr. and Mrs. Pennington, Mrs. Valadez, Mr. Leong, Mr. Campos, Mr. LaFleur, Ms. Klinger, Mrs. Richardson, Mr. Sanders, and Mrs. Perry. The name drop is real. Thank you to the members of the LUHSD Board and District Administration for laying the foundation of our school. Thank you to the family members and friends who are here supporting their students, allowing them to be where they are today. And then thank you to those watching online. Thank you so much for lending a portion of your time to listen to this speech. I don't know where the camera is, but maybe over there. Hi. And then thank you to Mrs. Rowland, who proofread my speech, helping further advance these amazing speaking skills you're about to listen to. Well, I guess we made it, guys. Congratulations to our graduating class of 2024, a great class full of many talented and wonderful people. Oh, wait, it's 2023? Oh, wait, sorry, guys, sorry. Okay, my bad. Okay. I'm kind of nervous right now, sorry. All right. This is my one and only chance to speak in front of a massive crowd full of gorgeous people. I literally spent a bunch of time in the mirror practicing this just for this to happen. Okay, I drink the water, we're all good. All right, let's go. All right, so look guys, I'm not afraid of messing up right now. And if I do, who cares? I mean, some people may mention this mistake to their family, maybe it might be all over the internet, but eventually, we'll forget that this ever happened. And that's a lesson that I learned from my 4 years of attending Heritage High School. You guys saw what I did there, right? Nice transition? Okay, but anyways, making mistakes is entirely fine because they are necessary for improvement. They are mainly personal stepping stones towards success. Granted, some stepping stones may be taller than others, some may be a bit more slippery, but as long as we put in the hard work and dedication to conquer each of these stepping stones, we will see gradual improvements. In general, our lives are not perfect. Everyone has moments that wanna make them lay in bed all day and not move a muscle. It can happen to anyone, even me. I've had instances of burnout or times where I required mental health breaks, and I literally questioned what I wanted to do with my life. At the time, I failed to realize that the struggles and sadness are what make life worth living. See here, guys, if life went so smoothly for everyone, we would feel empty on the inside because everything loses value without a relentless struggle. However, if we experience struggle and push through to finally achieve a goal, it makes it all the worth it because we have to give it our blood, sweat, and tears. Now, apply that lesson to every aspect of your life. If you want to be the best you can be, you will need to be willing to take chances, make mistakes, and get messy, said Ms. Frizzle from the Magic School Bus. And during struggle, please do not be afraid to ask for help. And of course, do not be afraid of judgment with your mistakes. You can never, ever satisfy the opinions of 8 billion people. It's literally statistically impossible. And that's fine. Differing opinions should not stop you from achieving your goal, as long as they do not impede on the well-being of society. And keep working hard. And remember, failure is entirely fine, as long as it's not from a lack of effort. And when you do succeed, even if it's really, really minuscule, please celebrate that movement forward. And class of 2023, carry these lessons into the future, and you should remember that you came this far to enter a new chapter of your life. And with that, I'll leave us off with one final message. Put in all of your effort to achieve a goal, even if it means messing up on the big stage. Thank you.
Thank you, Tien. Well, as Tien said, what's better than one valedictorian but two valedictorians? Valedictorian for the Heritage High School class of 2023 is Rebecca Lee. Rebecca graduates with a total GPA of 4.53 and will be attending UCLA to pursue a degree in biochemistry with a future goal of becoming an orthodontist. Rebecca has earned AP Scholar with Distinction awards in 2021 and 2022 for several of the 17 AP courses she has taken. She is a member and secretary of National Honor Society. Outside of Heritage, she has received her Certificate of Merit for piano each of the 10 years she has studied. In addition, she serves as secretary for the community-based tutoring group Educated Angel. Congratulations, Rebecca, on being named valedictorian for Heritage High School's class of 2023. Rebecca, please come forward.
I should first start off with a big thank you to my friends and teachers for holding my hand along this perilous journey, and to my dad and the Maddens for always being so nice and supportive. And a personal shout out to all my real ones out there, you know who you are. This is no small achievement because for 13 long years, or 14, I don't know if you guys did preschool, we've spent 6 to 7 hours, day in, day out, attending compulsory education. Along the way, there were some moments when it seemed that everything was gonna flop, at least for me. Specifically when we thought the world was ending in 2020. For some, we thrived within the confines of our own homes, and for others, we're still trying to catch up on a lost year. And to most of us, if not all, we're probably trying to do one of the scariest things known to mankind, which is figuring out what to do with the rest of our lives. So whether we're here today with straight A's or other colorful letters of the alphabet, we're still here graduating because despite whatever struggles we endured for the past decade, things worked out for us all. Whenever people ask me how I'm feeling on rough days, I usually say something along the lines of, oh, I'll be fine, I don't have a choice but for things to inevitably work out in the end. Now this probably sounds first and foremost very restrained, like, what, you don't have a choice. And second, very privileged, especially coming from a valedictorian. Because it seems as if no matter what I do, I'll still get everything through. I mean to say that even when things don't go my way and I fail a test, forget my homework, get rejected from a college, and poop just hits the fan, I still get to go play Roblox, fall asleep in my cozy bed, and start over in the morning. Because at the end of the day, there is always tomorrow, literally. I know this because after 14 long years, and yes, I did preschool, I discovered that things work out in two ways. I either wallow in yesterday and maybe come to terms with my misfortunes, or I move forward to tomorrow and make the best of what I have. Looking back at the past decade, I'd like to think that I've made it a habit to do the latter. But that's enough about me, because I'm not the only one on this field who's figuring out where to spend my potential. They say Hakuna Matata, and so can we, because while we don't have to decide this very instant what we want to do with ourselves after we get out of here, it's at least it's not our choice if things will work out, but it is our choice on how things work out. So, as we kiss goodbye to the ungodly traffic on the way to school, the dry chicken sandwiches, and of course, the highs and lows of high school football, my question to you is, will you choose to buckle your seatbelts and stay put, saying, hence we ball, and mere acceptance of your circumstances? Or will you yearn for the better, strive forward, and make the best of what you have? I say we do the latter. Thank you and congrats, class of 2023.
Thank you, Rebecca. At this time, our senior class president, Bianca Paniagua, will present a gift from the class of 2023 to future generations of patriots. Bianca, please come forward.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of the class of 2023, I wish to donate a monetary gift to the ASB account for the incoming freshman class of 2027 to help begin their journeys as patriots on our campus. Thank you.
Thank you, Bianca. And now, 2023, please stand. Mrs. Mendrick, I am honored to present to you members of the graduating class of 2023. I certify that each student here has met all of the requirements to graduate as specified by our board policies and in accordance with the education code of the state of California. Ms. Mendrick, your class of 2023.
Good evening. on behalf of the Liberty Union High School District Board of Trustees, I accept the class of 2023. Congratulations, and go on, be successful.
Thank you, Ms. Mendrick. Seniors, please be seated. I would like now to introduce the class of 2023 advisors, Mr. Grant Beyer and Mr. Kris Bonney, who will read the names of our graduates.
Alexandra Cutnelli.
Ian Hutween.
Maya Robinson.
Tien Hua.
Tristan Shutter.
Christopher Alaya Chin.
Summer Claiborne.
Evan Anderson.
Zaki Alexander.
Kayla Fernandez.
McKenna Sorek.
Charlotte Adams.
Raziel Issa Ardaniel.
Kyle Edward Rungi.
Kaden Burden.
Isabella Patricia Lanou.
Natalie Nasser.
Rebecca Lee.
Taylor Williams.
Braden Madden.
Vincenzo Caccioloni.
Aubrey Shore.
Clint Morgan Villanueva.
Caitlin McHugh.
Bianca Paniagua.
Mia Voqui.
Calista Reynoso.
Emma Lynn Hefner.
Gianna Mengenhauser.
Jordan Ratchford.
Kara Valdez.
Devin Rivers.
Morgan Deaver.
Michaela Rose Drury.
Ishika Khanna.
Jordan Nicole Davies.
Maya Naranjo.
Sydney Josie Flannery.
Liliana Pena.
Emma Kamali Cornell.
Iman Isaac.
Sydney Renee Kennedy.
Danissa Harovich.
McKenna Elizabeth James.
Solomon Gator.
Isabella Blandon.
Landon Marchetti.
Trua Simonton.
Cohen Wolf.
Valeria Espinoza.
Nicholas Leffel.
Juliana Letargo.
Nicholas Guidry.
Caitlin Smith.
Riley Pimentel.
Alicia Petroni.
Tomas Baluyat.
Zachary Lang.
Anthony Potestio.
Jace Wolf.
Gabriella Alves.
Farshad Nori.
Alyssa Cardamone.
Nevin Russell.
Madison Namura.
Daniel Gutierrez.
Chantel Villegas.
Jace Weatherby.
Taylor Sunga.
Miggy Fernandez.
Cole Sunga.
Jason Gripe.
Ella Jenkins.
Angel.
Michaela.
Donovan. Ellie Longoria.
Trinity Johnston.
Zoe Wells.
Matthew Molinari.
Azaria Grant.
Cayman Joseph Sargent.
Brianna Brown.
Lanaya Wilson.
Sean Hemby.
Bryshell Bryant.
Zane Baltz.
Celine Jamie.
Dallas Landarius.
Emily Chang.
Anthony Saw.
Jacob Chang.
Calvin Paras.
Joshua Chang.
Kaya Centron.
Jeremiah Ruffin.
Kamalani Mendoza.
Dominic Mills.
Robert Gifo.
Ryan Simons.
Isaiah Grayson.
Brock Lombardi.
Nagin Leah Isan.
Elijah Young.
D.D. Salazar.
Emmanuel Yulema.
Brooke Sluice.
Vang Pao Fradu.
Paige Sluice.
Elijah Sean Gallo.
Isabella Elnis.
Ethan Cardoza.
Liam Doherty.
Derek Boral.
Noor Ibrahim.
Angelica Watson.
Julia Ramey.
Kimberly Acosta.
Ariel Beal.
Matthew Dumas.
Beza DeWeet.
Michael Blaylock.
Hannah Smith.
Christopher Hardo.
Sabah Nasari.
Nikhil Shao.
Zayden Olawin.
Juliet Fajot.
Cyrus Gouda.
Amanda Muse.
Jared Melendez.
Perry Lindemann.
Jack Wooten.
Rihanna Rose.
Samantha Bracamonte.
Arthur Ray.
Isabella Calta-Gironi.
John Paul Salami.
Tanner Schultz.
Emily Stokes.
Nathaniel Van Dunwall.
Alyssa Sanabria.
Ethan Kaliwag.
Ashley Bilavaki.
Dylan Jeffrey Yee.
Bethany Durham.
Veronica Perez.
Michael McGregor.
Daniel Garcia.
Mason Tan.
Christopher Libby.
Matthew Vo.
Travis Barnes.
Brendan McNamara.
Felipe Velasser.
Austin Rubit.
Maria da Grace Bienhades.
Charlie Holland.
Skylar Stroh.
Brandon Schumacher.
Angelina Granadas.
Peyton Armadas.
Jerome Ramos Jr.
Liliana Martinez.
Jaden Lee.
Jordan Odiamba.
Jonathan Quintero.
Zachary Fleischman.
Hogan Irwin.
Dylan Kramer. Taryn Ritchie.
Arlo Peterson.
Abby Salgado.
Micah Amani Youngblood.
Brandon Simmons.
Tabitha Zoss.
Blake Shiro.
Carly Lindenwoski.
Brandon Castro.
Giselle Navarro.
William Trawbridge.
Meliana Mendoza.
Caleb Kyanen.
Teo Campbell.
Braden Geis.
Isaiah Javier.
Jasper Villanova.
Willie Japanese.
Mia Radeba.
Sophia Ochoa Aragon.
Ava Torres.
Kayla Wainwright.
Molly Eastwood.
Virginia White.
Emily Sanders.
Jaden Waters.
It's the same logic setup for the transmitter as well.
Xavier Contreras.
Shaylee Jones.
Wei Lang Kai.
Maria Wattenberg.
Brendan Chang. Kristen Tolentino.
Emily Steeper.
Nadia Smith.
Astrid Publico.
Leslie Gastelum.
Matthew Reyna.
Allison Carrasco.
Darian Larson.
Sophia Reyes Dominguez.
Bardon GT.
Athena Luong.
Mosca Napka.
Natalie Nuella.
Jasmine Lassiter.
Isabella Lopez.
Alyssa Rodriguez.
Lily Joya.
Emily Sampson.
Mateo Mendoza.
Lorenzo Yi.
Carlos Miguel Rivera.
Magwili. Colin Magwili. Yeah!
Philip Todd.
Mandy Shia.
Yeah, Mandy!
Mason Saeed.
Kaya Foskey.
Gabriel Vicente.
Bottengarner.
Zaina Bottengar.
Sunem Ramirez. Nario.
Kaylee Ann Nario.
Jacqueline Orta.
Madison Gallegos.
Emma Kramer.
Catalina De Amorotu.
Hannah Dotson.
Elijah Lopez.
Delaney Stevens.
Alexander Pelk.
Essence Hernandez.
Rashid Mohammed.
Alex Verduzco.
Harithik Moretti.
Paige Jabot.
Hadan Corona.
Brian Serta.
Christian Grande Flores.
Jorge Fernando Ihiqua.
Katrina Markovetsky.
Perla America Martinez.
Lance Long.
Amy Danielle Beltran.
Chanel Valancourt.
Frohar Monez.
Aaron Kumakawa.
Giselle Teresa Baiza.
Sophia Mora.
King Griffin Cologne.
Julia Hernandez.
Joey Chandler.
Xavion Spencer.
Nayeli Suhe Navarrete.
Oliver Church.
Sebastian Montoya.
Keanu Bryce Kabagbag.
Atasia Michelle Gibson.
Kyle Laureano Flores.
Electra Hauk.
Yuan Josh Ricafort.
I got you. Andrea Mazzola. Thank
you. Maxwell Simmons.
Cameron O'Keefe.
Mandy Ferreira.
Nafiz Youssef.
Jillian Molina.
Aaron Saifi.
Matthew Gonia.
Harley Smith.
Dalton Scott.
Justin Wise.
Corwin Fox.
Brandon Foy.
Cohen Steers.
Joseph Valverde.
Emma Pasek.
Hayden Bonden Odenaller.
Colin Santos.
Mikhail Sabir Ramirez.
Darlene Davies.
Kaylee Robinson.
Logan Williams.
JJ Johnston.
Joshua Navarro.
Jackson Marquez.
Nashley Ponochawa.
Madeline Custis.
Kyla Jones.
Ashley Amaro.
Ian Soria.
Kiara Reisner.
Adriana Sobolewski.
Summer Marie Faith Legamarsino.
Stefano Ricardo Nocenso.
T. Tatum Alisa Paige Wise.
Amy Corona.
Janeda Cotton.
Philip Isaac Soberano.
Alyssa Morgane.
Santiago Rodriguez Hernandez.
Cole Suvario.
Apollo Hassan.
Caden Coleman.
Teo Gallaga Anthony.
Lisa Gavor.
Demetrius Serengelis.
Sophia Kelty.
Mercedes Palacios Gonzalez.
Gavin Ferreira.
Megan Mancada.
Andrew Azevedo Del Bricado.
Zeta Williams.
Alan Sanic.
Sane Presley.
Devani Bauer.
Julia Gadomski.
Sahil Sohi.
Charlene Carr.
Sean Souza.
Saralina Gafara.
Bella McVicker.
Ari Velasquez.
Zachary Weiss.
Elijah Joaquin Martin Soriano.
Samara Lowrush.
Alexander Charles Matthias Henderson.
Annabella Garania.
Maya Catherine Reed.
Christopher Moseka.
Anaya Nicole McKesson.
Javier Zach Espara.
Jaden Elizabeth Mendez Finger.
Kalima Muhammad.
Ruby Garo.
Carielle Villanueva.
Kaylee Collison.
Hannah Grace Mackey.
Emma Green.
Nathaniel Valentino Rios.
Tristan Derflinger.
Davin Marie.
Tristan Cazares.
Marco Carrillo.
Isaiah Lopez Sandoval.
Natalie Fasacci.
Jesse DeWall.
Anna Maria Ocean New.
Nija Khalees Gibson.
Noah Mumi.
Tiana Brown.
Richard Rocio.
Daryl Lee Hawkins Jr.
Julia Cook.
Cooper Shea Muzia.
Reagan Esperanza DeRoche.
Andres Mateo Gamboa.
Gabriel Reynolds.
Mauricio Alberto Granera.
Lucas Riego Diedos.
Nathaniel Sandoval.
Lance Riego Diedos.
Caleb Easley.
James Sonny Chesney.
Alishaba Ali.
Dominic Ortega.
Marjan Alizai.
Brandon Nazir.
Kenneth Vong.
Zyra Clarice Lara.
Nui Luong.
Adena Iwa.
Priya Bangar.
Yeah! Yes, sir. Basu Aurora.
Ashley Marshall.
Alexander Hurd.
Alicia Casey. Yeah.
Maya Alfonso.
Laquan Mabry. Yeah.
Dominic Garish.
Marwin Cruz. Let's go,
Marwin. Francine Guerrero.
Micah Mueller.
Steven Zhang.
Caden Hart.
Nayea Evanchek.
Joey Irba.
Kaylee Gonzalez.
Marshall.
Salep Marshall.
Tamiana Owensby.
Jason Brady Martin.
Braden McGay.
Santana John David Valdez.
Kaya Block.
Giro Albanza.
Cameron Block.
Aiden Tabakovich.
Sincheco Agulandaka.
Connor Francis Toll.
Matthew Horgan.
Makta Alamaya.
Kaylee Paez.
Jada Angelita.
Emma Arnett Omdi.
Joshua Barrett.
Araya Stallings.
Ethan Hookton.
Kimora McLemore.
Preston Umad.
Kalissa Root.
Jenna Cruz.
Hope Bioto.
Daniela Ban.
Munoz.
Nikki Nguyen.
Sahana Err.
Gabrielle Dowdy.
Antonia Faith George.
Diego Miguel Caribbean.
Gracie Ann Brand.
Therese Cabernet.
Javon Payne-Lenu.
Chloe Beck.
Nicholas Gain.
Kiera Mullen.
Ava Ganea.
Leanne Copley.
Carmina Tandima.
Sydney Klein.
Hayden Pate.
Trinity Summer Castle.
Brady Stinn.
Vanessa Gabrielle Charles.
Dominic Carrillo.
Angelina Gabriela Espinoza.
James Barang.
Adil Hamed.
Raul Estrada.
Zane Hanan.
Moises Cortez Rojas.
Jelena Hernandez.
Arden Commons.
Madison Cruz.
Daisy Rivera.
Madison Tall.
Idra Ania.
Cassidy Hannon.
Travis Bibby.
Mitzi Ramos.
Kylie Johnson.
Allison Wadley.
Alona Signe Kane.
Megan Sun.
Christopher Luby Kennedy.
Muskan Arzo Amadi.
Justin McIntosh.
Sophia Sheeman.
Valerie Macha Ramos.
Justin Rodriguez.
Daniel Mureo.
Jacob Montalvo.
Marcus Monasterio.
Nigel Lumbang.
Richard Mendoza.
Julita Cuzares.
Ashlyn Sienna Lago.
Annalise Coker.
Alexandra Sierra.
Kendall Eichler.
Caleb King.
Cedric Zerardi.
Yeah. Ricardo Point Dujour.
Joseph Haggart.
Jeremiah Young.
Isaac Haggart.
Dewan Brown.
Adam Jeffries.
Janae Cottrell.
Elijah Del Prado.
Vanessa Robles.
Christian Lagang.
Olivia Diaz.
Jaden Cicello.
Alexandra Hernandez.
Kate Maureen Ramirez.
Isabella Galau.
Janelle Buenaflor.
Madison Reed.
Kaden Waylon Howe.
Bailey Newberry.
Monique Morales.
Brandon Newberry.
Fufu Pan.
Annie Villa.
Inman. Emily Seymour Inman.
Madeline Marie Washburn.
Jordan Pauline.
Matthew Eichler.
Jordan Alika Maldonado.
Christian Viveros.
Zarek Araneta. Yeah!
Caitlin Dugan.
Harrison Duran.
Molly Dugan.
Lexi Marisol Tibbin.
Bryce Ellenberger.
McKenna Noel Law.
Emmanuel Quinones.
Vanch Dua.
Lindsay Moore.
Levi Waller.
Faith Gruba.
Giancarlo Maba Bang Lao.
Gagandeep Kaur.
Elias Dardar.
Amarissa Aceves.
Savani Reed. Catherine Aaron.
Thank you, Mr. Byer and Mr. Bonney. Great job. Class of 2023. Class of 2023. I want to say that there is no better class that I would rather spend my final graduation with at Heritage. Thank you to the Liberty Union Board of Trustees and to Superintendent Eric Volta for giving me the opportunity to serve these last 6 years as principal. At this time, I would ask that rows 1 through 3 please stand and follow your staff honor guard to the front half of the stadium to form our Block H as one last symbolic gesture, being united as a graduating class. Student Body President Iman Isaac will now lead the class of 2023 in the time-honored tradition of turning the tassels.
With the class of 2023, please join me in turning our tassels from right to left. Congratulations!
At this time, Mr. Kumagai will conduct the band as they play the Heritage Fight Song and Recessional. Congratulations, students and families, and have a great summer. We're taking a picture with the balloon.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow.